If you're interested in art and animation, you need to learn about the amazing tool that MIT didn't put into Scratch. Onion skinning is a technique that goes back to the earliest days of movie making, when artists used thin sheets of paper called onion skin to plan out their animation projects.
Each animator's drawing board is lighted from below. He looks through the paper at the character he has previously outlined and draws the next movement in correct position.
You won't find an onion skinning feature in the standard version of Scratch, which is a real shame because you're stuck using trial and error to judge how you should move your characters to make the animation look realistic. To get this amazing feature working in Scratch, you're going to need to install Scratch Add-Ons, a third-party utility that adds more than 150 new features to Scratch. Created by a community of passionate Scratchers from around the world, Scratch Add-Ons is totally free and super easy to install. Just navigate over to scratchaddons.com and click to install the software as an extension for your Chrome, Firefox, or Edge browser. Once installed, a new orange icon should appear in the extensions menu at the top right of your browser. In Chrome, you need to click the puzzle button and pin the extension to your menu to make it visible. Click the orange button to launch the extension, then click the settings gear to access the full collection of add-ons. There are lots of cool tools to experiment with here, including fun reskinning tools that let you totally redesign the look of the Scratch interface. To find the onion skin add-on, just type onion in the search window and click this button to enable the add-on. Over in Scratch's costume editor, you'll find two new buttons next to your magnifying glass tool. Click the left button to switch on your onion skin. You won't see anything new happen until you duplicate your costume and make a small change. I've moved Pixel's arm here, but a ghostly version remains on the screen, showing me where his arm was in the previous frame. To create great animations, you'll need to make a bunch of very small movements, and you can use this ghost image to plan out your movements so they look natural. Once you're happy with your new pose, duplicate your costume again. Our onion skin looks like it's disappeared because our new image is a perfect duplicate of the frame that came before it. Let's rotate Pixel's arm some more, and now our onion skin is visible again. The button next to the on-off switch is a settings window that lets you tweak how your onion skin works. Let's change the number of previous costumes to 2. Now I can see how far I moved Pixel's arm between costume 1 and costume 2, and use that information to decide how far to move in the next frame. You can use this opacity button to make your ghost image more or less transparent. Instead of viewing the previous frame, you can also use your onion skin to map out where you want to go in the future. Let's draw a new frame that shows where I want Pixel's body parts to be a few frames from now. In the settings window, make the next costume visible. And now we can see what the goal is that we're moving towards and start to plan out how we're going to get there. This type of animation, where you create a starting pose and an end pose, then go back and fill in the movements in the middle, is called tweening. And it's actually how a lot of professional animators plan out their projects. Once you've finished a few frames of animation, you'll probably want to see how your new cartoon looks in action. One easy technique I like to use to preview my animations is to just add a next costume block to a when space key pressed block. Now I can cycle through my animation at whatever speed I want and tweak the frames until everything looks smooth. With a bit of practice and the power of onion skin, you'll soon be animating like a pro.
I see over the liftoff. The clock has started. Roger.